name is Brittany. I am 30 years old. I live in Chipley, Florida, and I am covered from head to toe in cysts. I have them up here. These are the squishy ones. When they get inflamed, it feels like a hot ice pick being stabbed. I have one here. This one feels more like a sack full of cottage cheese. I have them from my torso and all the way down. It's covered. The one on my chin that hangs, stuff comes out of that one. But by popping them, none of them ever go away. It just eases the pain when they're inflamed. Hey guys, I need to step back for a second. I'm starting to get a really bad headache. Okay. I was born with neurofibromatosis type 1, and majority of every day I have pain. And they're really inflamed right now. Mm. Robbie is my boys' father. He looked past my disorder from day one, and my two boys are just my biggest supporters. But my kids get made fun of because of the way I look. It hurts them and it breaks their heart. So I try not to go to too many school functions and stuff for them. I've been told multiple times that I look like a monster. I've had adults trying to get their kids to laugh too. I try to brush it off as much as I can, but it's hard. I get very depressed. I honestly think I'm ugly. I feel I was supposed to be in a different body and not the body that I'm in. Because the body I'm in, I hate. I'm in a constant stage of pain management. Every single day I wake up, I don't know what's gonna hurt me next. Growing up, I had went and seen all these doctors to take off the cyst, but they consider it cosmetic anytime you wanna take something off of you. They just wanna say, here, and here's medicine. I'm not gonna help you take it off. I just want you to keep coming in every month and put more medicine in your system. Medicine's not a cure-all, and I do not like taking pills. But I've been using a lot of aromatherapies lately, and it helps with the pain.
What are you doing?
I am making essential roll-on for headaches. I live with my parents. We stay here with my two kids. I have a problem getting jobs based on what I look like. They ask me, is there anything I can do to cover it up? And I have told them, no, there's not. And then they turn around and say, oh, well, we're not hiring for this position anyway.
I like this for the inflammation. It really does help with the cyst I have on this side.
So NF started with my mom's grandpa, and then my mom's mom, my mother, and then me.
But mine is more external.
Yours is more visible. I'm sorry. It came from me. As Brittany's mom, I feel bad. And I would like to see Brittany succeed in life. And Brittany will have to learn to provide for herself and her children because, I mean, we're not gonna be there forever. You honestly need to know your worth in life, Brittany. You're beautiful regardless.
Trying to make me cry.
I'm not trying to make you cry.
I know Dr. Lee would not be able to cure my disorder that I have, but if she was able to help in some of the areas that are my more concerning areas, then I'm able to support my two children on my own and not rely on my parents. That, to me, would make my world.
Hello,
I'm Brittany. I'm here to see Dr. Lee.
Okay, yeah.
For my whole entire life, Doctors have never removed anything from me, any of the cyst or anything. So she's able to tackle some of the problem areas.
Go ahead and have a seat. Dr. Lee will be right with you, okay?
All right, thank you, ma'am. It would give me my self-confidence back so I can be able to pursue a better life for me and my children.
Hello. Good morning, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Are you Brittany?
Yes, ma'am.
Nice to meet you. I'm Sandra. Well, what brings you here? I feel like you have neurofibromatosis.
Yes, ma'am. I have neurofibromatosis type 1.
So you were essentially born with this.
Yes, ma'am.
Correct. Okay, so you have, I would assume you've seen a lot of dermatologists and other doctors too?
All the time, and they just don't help.
So they kind of stick out more so on the surface.
I have it on the surface.
It's interesting how neurofibromatosis is so
different.
Similar yet different.
Like my mother has it more on the inside. And we both have the same type.
Yes. Okay, well, let me take a look at some of these areas.
Okay.
I don't want to promise you anything before I take a look, okay? Brittany is wonderful. And it's really shocking to me that she has thousands of bumps and she has not had a single one removed. So even in one person, things can get complicated. There are different kinds of growths that can occur. So I really need to assess what she has going on and manage her expectations. Okay, I'll start from the top here. So this one, I feel a little something there at the base. My concern is sometimes when you remove a neurofibroma and you just shave it off flat, there's still some underneath. So
yeah.
It will sometimes just push out again. Let me take a look at that one on your chin. Yeah, that one looks pretty straightforward though too. So I feel like if I get these ones that stick out, like here, here, and these that are really sticking out and around your nose,
that would make them world of difference, especially around my nose. Yeah.
Okay, so now we have, you can put that back on.
We have the big mama.
The big mama. Is that what you call it? Ah, he's cute though. It's like I can almost fit my two hands together, you know, they're touching.
Oh yeah.
So that means that I can really kind of take this off and just stitch it. I think that would be really nice to just have a little line scar there. Brittany has many visible neurofibromas, and she knows as well as I that we can't make this go away, but I want her to feel more confident, and this does not dictate her life. She can do something to sort of have some control over it. So I think that the best course of action here is to really assess the ones that are the most noticeable, the most symptomatic for her, and try to remove those. Certainly, we're gonna try to get to as many of them as I can, for sure.
Okay.
Okay?
Sounds good to me.
Okay, great.
Dr. Lee being able to do this for me means the world. I'm so excited and,
Okay, so I'm gonna numb up these bigger areas and then probably around her mouth too. Every neurofibroma is rarely unique, and you can't predict how it's gonna act. One will be like an iceberg where you just see the very tip of it, and there's a much bigger area of tissue underneath. You also don't want to remove a lot of normal tissue because you can be left with an indentation, and that can look just as bad. And you really need to be careful and conservative to try to figure out where this is and leave the proper amount of skin to try to keep this looking as normal as you can. Be ready to go. Let me know if anything hurts. Brittany really is such a trooper. I think that multiple treatments she's certainly going to benefit from. So I really look forward to seeing her again, but I think she's gonna be really pleased with what we've done, certainly so far. Here you go, take a look at what we did here. Oh, careful. What do you think?
I feel like my whole life has been about this moment. It's finally happened. Can I hug you?
Oh, of course you can.
Oh my gosh. I don't know rather if I should cry or smile or laugh. My shape of my face is so much more even, and I don't have anything hanging off of my chin. I already feel like 1,000 pounds have been lifted off my shoulder. It's amazing how it can happen in the blink of an eye.
I would love it if we could do a two-parter here.
Okay.
Like, I feel like we can go back and get some fine-tuning.
Okay,
that would be really nice. I'd be really happy to do that.
I'm happy.
Okay, good. I'm happy for you, too. Okay, and so I will see you soon, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Feel like a lot of changes are coming my way.